This animal is the cephalopod lover's dream animal. It's Octopus churchii, or the lesser Pacific striped octopus. This guy's small, about the size of a quarter. You find these little octopus in the Pacific coast of Central America in the intertidal zone. So shallow water, just off the beach. What makes this octopus so striking is it's got these kind of black and white or black and cream stripes. It's got chromatophores in its skin, and it doesn't get different colors really, but it'll change the density of the stripes. It's just kind of gorgeous. I don't know any other way to describe it except when I look at it, I'm very happy. This is my secret home lab. This is where the magic happens. All this is now fish or fish breeding, and I grow some coral in here now. And I got this rack specifically with the idea of breeding octopuses in mind. That's the larger Pacific striped octopus. I am studying this animal because I love this animal. This animal is one of the ones when I first started getting into cephalopods that I thought I would never, ever see alive. And I've got six of them over there right now. Two females and four males. Telling the sex of cephalopods can be really difficult. The lesser Pacific striped octopus is actually very easy to tell if it's a male or a female. On the ends of their arms, the female has just suckers, but the male has this little kind of fuzzy papillae. And once you're able to spot the difference, they're actually very easy to sex, which makes your life as a cephalopod escort service, I guess. It makes it very easy. And it's on. When you're an octopus, having your lover eat you is always a possibility. Generally, how these guys mate is with the male as far away from the female as possible. The male octopus has a modified arm called a hectocotylized arm, and that actually goes inside the mantle. It's more complicated than that. You can see his arm just behind these bunches of arms. One arm is inside of her mantle cavity. The penis delivers the sperm down the arm through peristaltasis, like when you swallow. You know, the groove in the arm kind of squeezes in and out and pushes the sperm packet forward. And then that gets to a thing on the tip of the hectocotylized arm called the ligula. And the ligula is what the octopus actually uses to place the sperm packet. Ooh, spermatophores. Wow. Did I mention octopuses are amazing and cool? They really are. There we go. Nice exit. How long before the female lays an egg clutch? That's a hard question to answer. One of the things I'm hoping to find out when I have completely closed the life cycle is being able to answer that question. We know it's iteroporous, meaning it has multiple clutches of eggs, so it's not just one bunch of eggs and then they die like other octopuses do. They keep on going, which is a big deal. Almost no other octopuses do that. It's got large eggs. And in cephalopods, large eggs means big babies, and big babies generally means not a larval phase. There's not that many octopuses that hatch out as mini adults. These octopuses live for about a year to a year and a half. I'm not saddened by their short lives. If you've been doing this for 10 or 15 years like I have, you get used to that as a fact of life. It's actually kind of beautiful because it's our life, but just compressed down into a year. I think cephalopods in general are the coolest animals in the world, and I've got them in my house, and I'm doing useful work with them. What more could you ask?